Right, so with BNB falling to the wayside, the question is, where will Cav go? Obviously, a lot of other people are out of contract as well, and that is not great at all. But at the end of the day, the person who really I think most people are probably interested in is Cav. So we have the rule, the teams here of who basically who he could possibly sign with. Now, the key thing to remember on this is that for World Tour, you can't really have more than 30. There's some weird thing with Neo Pros, but basically, if they're at 30, they can't sign them. So that rules out Alpecin De Koninck, which is like probably quite a classic team for him to go to. A lot of sprinty boys and good lead out. Astana, no, he's never going to go there. Bora is like a maybe with the Specialized connection. Obviously, good relationship, Specialized. Cofidis, okay, he's never going there. EF is another maybe, but that can't happen. And Movistar, he was linked with them because Max Chandri is the DS there and he knows him quite well from the days of British cycling. And Bike Exchange, which another Anglo team could do it. And let's be honest, DSM, there's no way he'd go there because he's not doing his homework the day before races. So the teams it leaves with, he's not going to, I reckon, a French team. I don't think he'd go to AG2R. I don't think he'd go to Groupama. So that kind of rules them out. Bahrain Victorious is like a maybe again because he had ridden for them before. We're going to have a check out of their team. INEOS, I want to speak about a lot because I think that's more likely. Intermarché is a maybe. Jumbo is a maybe, but no, not really, because they'll go. Well, they want to win the tour again. Quick Step, well, they binned him off. And I don't think they'd want to re-sign him. I don't think he'd want to stay at Quick Step because he's not going to go to the tour. Arkea is a very interesting one. Trek is a maybe, and UAE is UAE. And again, I can't imagine that he would go there just because they probably want to win the tour with Tadej, and I'm not sure if you can have a sprint lead out and try and win the tour anymore. It's quite hard to do. And then the other one we'll go to is Israel, because I think there is a good chance that he could end up there. The other ones like Bardiani, like Kiepe Kern Farmer, Euskaltel, like yeah, they might get invited to the tour, but probably won't. Caporal is again maybe, but like, I just can't see him going to like a no disrespect, but a small non-English speaking team. Yeah, I just don't see it happening. Q36 and a half again, they're just not going to the tour. So like the only one who guaranteed to the tour is Total Energy. But again, it's a French speaking team with Sagan. I can't imagine he'd go there. And Uno X, it doesn't really fit their style. So we'll go through the team sort of, and see how it would go. So for 2023, obviously these are all kind of rumors. But I reckon this is a decent team for him to go to. Okay, Landa will go for the tour, but that, in itself is not a massive issue. They've got quite a good lead out. You can imagine Fred Wright would do well in leading out. Jonathan Milan is a very strong sprinter, but also a track man who probably could help him lead out as well. Heinrich Hausler is also good at leading out. Phil Bauhaus again. So this is a potential. He has been on the team before, so I don't know if there's bad blood. Well, I don't know. You don't just don't know if there's like, good blood or bad blood, or like how the relationship is between them. He might have left on bad terms, he might have left on good terms, you just don't know. So it will either be, yeah, they really liked him and maybe they'll have him back, or nah, they didn't enjoy him as much, so maybe they won't. So again, I think this is a strong possibility, but I wouldn't say it's the most likely possibility. We're going to go to the lowest likely, which I think is INEOS last. Intermarché, again, the reason I don't think they'd have the budget for him. And also, I think the other issue is with Intermarché is like they've already spent quite a lot. Like they signed Lilian Calmajani, who won't be cheap because he's won a stage of the Tour and the Vuelta. Sam Rui Costa, again, well, former world champion. They re-signed Binyam for years, so that's probably quite a lot of money. And then like some of the other guys, probably like Herbert Thijssen and some of the other guys who started winning some races last year may have got increase in salary as well. So it could happen. They would have quite a good lead out. Bistrom is good at leading out. Kirby Gersens is a good sprinter, probably could do some lead out duties as well. As well as Adrien Petit as well, I reckon, and Lorenzo Rota. Some of these guys, you could imagine putting a team together in the tour. But again, I'm not 100% sure it's likely. Jumbo, as I previously said, I think there's zero chance they'll do this one, just because like the lead out wouldn't be great, but also the biggest issue would be that they don't they already if they're already splitting it with Wout and everyone else, there's just no way he can go to the tour with Jumbo. So that's a no chance. Arkea, I think, is an interesting possibility. They obviously binned off Quintana, so they'll have like a lot of money. They haven't really signed any massive names. Christian Rodriguez is very good, but he wouldn't have cost much. Again, they got a lot of French riders, okay, for sure, but they do have Dan McClay, and he is a very good lead out man. As well as, you know, there's quite a lot. Hugo Hofstetter as well, he could probably do a decent lead out job as well. And they obviously have Buhani, who was a very good, well, like, you know, he wanted a good lead out. So again, I believe he could go here. French sponsor as well, the Tour de France, you know, that it could happen. It's a bigger French team. I don't think FDJ or AG Zouar would happen just because I just don't know. I don't think they're as international, but, and also they sort of have, they either have a sprint squad or they don't. And AG2R, I don't think would want to gain one. And for FDJ, they got Demar. So this is a possibility. I think Trek is a really interesting possibility as well, mainly because it's like obviously quite an Anglo team, and they have good lead out people. Mikas Hulgaard, Dan Hull, people like them are big boys. Emilius Leipinch is very strong as well. Even like Mollema, Jakob Mosca, he's a decent sprinter. Quinn Simmons, Pedersen, they got a lot. But again, you say Pedersen, you're like, well, they've already got a sprinter. They've already got a guy who, like, is really good. And, you know, would they might have promised him you can go to the tour again, and then Cav comes in, so it's difficult. So, again, Trek is not as likely. UAE, I think, is the same thing. It's not going to happen because the tour. So I think we can bin them off. And then we come to another last sort of before you go to INEOS option, which is Israel. Now, Israel, they need an invite to the tour. Cav needs to go to the tour. So big risk signing here. But also, it could be good because there's a high chance that if they sign Cav, they'll get an invite to the tour. Now, B&B have folded. There is definitely a space open. And it will either go to a Spanish team because it starts in the Basque country, or it will go to Uno X because everyone just seems to love Uno X for no apparent reason. Or it goes to Israel. And Israel, to be fair, do have a lot of good riders. Like, obviously, Froome, if he actually has an OK season, that's a big reason to sign them. And then they've also got other people like Dylan Turns, who is actually really good. As well as Mike Woods, he is actually good as well. A lot of the other guys, okay, not top riders, but obviously still good, but not unreal. And their sprinter, Nizzolo, is just doesn't really compare to Cav. So I think actually, again, I'm pretty convinced that he could go there. However, I think the most reasonable team to go to is INEOS. Now, obviously, they're English and, you know, all the rest of it. They got zero chance of winning the tour this year. Let's be honest, this is just not going to happen. So then you think, okay, well, if you can't win the tour, what's the point of like having the biggest budget in pro cycling and not doing anything? Like, I honestly think if they just cracked on and had a lead out for him, so you could have like people like Ethan Hayter, very good at leading out, Kwiatkowski, very good at leading out, Pidcock again would be decent at leading out, Luke Rowe controls it, Sheffield, like Ben Swift's good at leading out, Ben Swift and Connor Swift are both very good at leading out, G can lead out as well as be a tall man, like Ben Turner, they have such a strong lead out squad if they need to. Ghana, of course, as well. So I think in reality, the team that makes most sense to go to is INEOS. They don't have a sprinter either. So, you know, Kim Heidegger is good, but like he's not going to the tour and winning. So this is why I think Cavendish, if they still have space, which I believe they do, they should sign Cav, bring him to the tour and just get him that last jersey. Because I think publicity-wise, that's far larger than anything else that this team will do at the tour. And I also believe strongly that Jim Ratcliffe will definitely want to have some sort of success. And Cav winning the 35th stage in the British National Champs jersey in INEOS kit, I think would be a story that is so big and so large that it makes 100% certainty that you have to do that. So yeah, those are my thoughts on where Cav will go. Let me know what you think below. But I think surely he has to go to INEOS. I think more likely is Israel. I think that's probably the, you know, my number one bet. But I think logically, INEOS makes most sense for Cav, and it makes most sense for INEOS. So anyway, cheers for watching. Hope you did enjoy, and I'll see you in the next one.